Hey guys, Ben from Ben's Boot Camp. Wanted to shoot you a video about the plank variation that we're now using in boot camp quite a lot. It's called the pull plank, P-U-L-L. It starts with a regular plank. Regular plank, if you don't, I'll demonstrate in a minute. If you don't know what that is, you get on your elbows, get on your toes, and you bridge, and you hold that for X amount of time. Pull plank, you do the same thing, except it varies it a little bit, so it forces you to use your stomach. All right, you bridge up immediately, forces you to use your stomach, and you have to engage your abs to stabilize. Now, a lot of times with a regular plank, what happens is people tend to complain of back pain, or their hips tend to sag, or sometimes they're coming too high. This eliminates two out of those three options. You can still get your hips pretty high, but what actually happens when your hips are really high, it makes it a little harder. So rather than making it easier with a regular plank. So there's a tendency to kind of have the hips a little bit low on this, but what you can do is kind of tell them to tighten up a little bit more if you're instructing how to do a pull plank, which I'm going to demonstrate right now. But it cleans up a lot of issues with weak stomachs, not doing planks correctly, or not getting much out of the plank, or causing back pain or back issues. So I'm going to demonstrate that for you right now. I'm going to position this camera here. Hopefully you can see it, see what I'm talking about, and then I'm going to demonstrate both for you. So, with a regular plank, I'm going to demonstrate that first. I'm going to roll my pant legs up to show you, as my dog comes to say hi. Okay, a regular plank starts like this. You get on your elbows, and then you're going to be on your toes. I don't know if you can see that. But I'm up on my toes right now. That's a regular plank, a bridge and hold. Now a pull plank, I'm going to come flat on the tops of my feet where my shoelaces would be, bring my elbows out in front a little bit more, and then I'm going to bridge and pull my body toward my elbows, but hold that pull. Okay? It immediately causes you to engage your stomach. To show you that again, flat on the tops of my feet, bridge up, and then pull to hold that pull. Okay? It makes it a lot harder and forces your abs to engage. So you won't be able to hold it as long, but it's going to clean up, like I said, clean up a lot of issues with hips sagging, not feeling it in your stomach. What we used to do is tell people to tighten up their glutes or tighten up their butt and suck in their stomach. That works for some people, but I find trying this variation, it really wakes up people's stomachs to engage the plank position and to stabilize like it should. So give that pull plank variation a shot, and let me know how it goes. You're gonna feel it in your stomach quite a lot. So give it a shot, guys.